Jersey. They had their seventh and last child. It was a boy named Joseph. He hardly knew his father because he passed away when Joe was only four. As a boy, Joe fished in the odd hand and went swimming in the Patterson Falls. So he was a survivor. He was a guy who grew up with seven brothers and sisters and survived that. Little Christopher might know him. He worshiped his mother. His mother raised seven children by herself and did odds and ends to make enough money to pay bills. Joe Fulco, he was part of the America's Greatest Generation. He was a Navy man to the core, and he served on the USS Miami in World War II. He was part of Admiral Halsey's Third Fleet that fought in the Pacific near Guam, Formosa, and Philippines. They participated in one of the greatest natural disasters in naval history when they sailed into Typhoon Cobra. 790 men died. Spoke to Joe about it one day, and he said it was like a cork in a bathtub. We bounced around. He said, I was feeling sick, I needed some air, so I climbed up the ladder, and I opened the port, and the boat was standing straight up in the water. He slammed it shut, and he fell down, and he got sick in the boat, and we left. He left his hearing during the war. He lost 100% of his hearing in his left ear, and 80% his right ear. But after the war, he met Rosie, or he knew Rosie, married his childhood sweetheart. We found a letter, Linda found a letter the other day that he had written to Rosie and said, I wish I knew you when we were six so I could have loved you for so many more years. He lived his life, adored this woman, and his only goal was to make her happy. But he had two daughters, Linda and Christine, seven grandchildren, three great-grandchildren, and his adopted son, Alex. Alex was his nephew. Was a father to Alex, and Alex, you should be up here doing this because this is tough. Joe's occupation was a carpenter. He was very precise. He crafted everything by hand. The first time I went to the house, I noticed where all the paneling was, there was no molding. Joe cut things razor edge. He was unbelievable. He built beautiful mansions and doll houses and toolboxes for his grandchildren. After his retirement, Joe enjoyed gardening, turned his creative energies into building and tending vegetable and flower gardens, and his hobbies included fishing, playing pool, doing jigsaw puzzles, and playing chess. Now, this was a very patient man. He taught his children, his grandchildren, his nephew, he taught them all how to fish. They all got fishing poles, tackle boxes. He lived in Wayne, New Jersey, where in the basement he had a pool table. Everyone learned how to play pool. But no one could move the pool ball around the table like Joe. Joe knew English like we all wanted to. He was a carpenter. This is where he really shone. He had incredible skills. He explained how to use a power tool, and then he explained what they did before it was a power tool. If you asked him, how do you tie a sailor's knot, he didn't explain, he showed you how to tie a sailor's knot. I built a deck in my yard one day. Joe, he helped us. But before we built the deck, Joe made us dig a hole and he put 3-foot cubes in the ground and put 2 steel outer cubes. And that held up the entire deck. All my neighbors had 12 poles. No, Joe did everything the right way. And he said, if there's ever a hurricane, hold on to the deck, it's not going anywhere. We used to play cards with him. He'd laugh, he'd cheat. But he was Italian and we all cheated in college, so it was one of the things we laughed at. He did it all and he did it with a smile on his face. Joe was a man who loved life. He lived it to the fullest and he enjoyed himself every day. He loved to play practical jokes, but he could take it as well as he could give it. One day we were sitting at dinner and I opened a bottle of wine and he took the cork. As I was sitting there, he bounced the cork off the table and went right above us. So I took the cork out and I tried to bounce it. I missed. He threw it back. Did he do it again? I missed. Do it again. So this became the battle of the corks. It was about a 10-year period we had. Realizing I couldn't beat him, one night I snuck downstairs while he was sleeping and I took corks and I stuck them in both of his shoes. So he woke up, obviously had a struggle putting his shoes on. So he came upstairs, big smile on his face, and he said, I had a problem with my right, she was on the small. So I left, he went off to the Friendship Club. I got ready for work, and as when I tried to put my hand in the handle of the car, there were the corks. I got a smile on there, they got me. It was raining, I turned on the windshield wiper, there went another cork across the windshield. So this went on for 10 years. I put them in his bed, he put them in my coat. He was a really marvelous man. The most striking thing about Joe was his ability to love. He loved and adored Rosie. She was his childhood sweetheart. After Rosie passed, he touched a picture every night. Joe slept in what I called the Rosie force field. On one side of the bed on the dresser was her picture, and in the bed on the other side was her picture. He touched a picture every night and told her how much he loved her. You know, all the ladies at the Friendship Club, they all wanted him. This was a sweet man. They teased him when he came home one day and he said, you know, they all think I'm gay. I didn't think you're gay, he said, because I won't go with them. So what do you tell them? He says, I tell them they're not Rosie. I love Rosie. Now this was 14 years after she died. So, I mean, this is true love. And today we are together again. But Joe also loved his children, his grandchildren, and his great-grandchildren. He was the man who stepped up whenever they needed him, or he just loved them just for the sake of making them smile. 3 days before he died, I took my grandson and I put him on the bed. So Luciano was staring at a teddy bear that Joey had given Joe. And Joe slept with this teddy bear every night. So he looked at Luciano and said, you want the bear? Luciano said, yeah. And I wanted to teach Joe. I said, Joe, tell him his name, because I knew he had named the bear. And he looked at me with that smile on his face and he said, the bear's name is Albert. So he got the last shot again, and I love him very much. His daughter, Linda, who took care of him for the last 14 years, every night she would say, they had this little game. She wanted to say, I love you, but before she would be able to say it, he would say, I love you more. So she would say, I love you more, he would say, I love you more, she would say, I love you more. And this is who he was. He did the same thing with Janine, his granddaughter. She'd come home, oh, Grandpa, I love you so much. And he'd say, yeah, but I love you more. And he did. Oh, hugging. You know, Joe had the knack of hugging women, nurses. The nurse came over, what can I do for you? Give me a hug. And I was told just the other day, he was the kind of guy that when he hugged you, you knew he meant it. He was a wonderful man. He taught us all a lot. But the most important thing he taught us was how to love one another. That was his number one teaching. Today we say goodbye to my friend, my father, and my drinking buddy. Shiga.
I understand it.